guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. They'll run with a big man, Bo Jackson. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for defense.
Dang, bro, he came back for that, bro.
Picked off by Jamal Adams, and he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
I know how to beat that. You make mistakes to learn from. He don't like to do. He's weird. He likes to spin. Okay, now he's stupid.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. A gain of 13. It's a first down. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Now they run the ball, man. Get sat down, man. Stop running.
Backed up to the 24.
He wasn't ready.
It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
54. Watch the screen.
Play action now. Here's Mayfield.
Ah, he can't catch.
George Kittle, the receiver that he was looking for. And it'll bring up third down. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. On third down, Mayfield.
Break that up. Let's go.
That one is incomplete. And it also concludes quarter number one. A pretty wild first quarter.
Better just take your point.
21-7, our score.
Things are weird.
Now look at this, 4th and 12, and they're going to line up to go for it. Now Mayfield on 4th down.
And of course they let him get that shit.
Kittle, and he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. A 24-yard touchdown. And the Redskins are able to stretch the lead out further. Vinatieri connecting on the extra point. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. And here's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. This will be taken short. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They're down 3 touchdowns to this point, needing to put something together as they have it 1st and 10. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw.
Oh, they hold him.
Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. 2nd down.
50 to Mike, 50 to Mike.
On the 30 as they come up 2nd and 10. To throw, Mayfield. Flushed out right. Got a man on the right sideline.
Ooh, I made a ball.
He's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. But one thing's for sure, they're going to have to come up with something at halftime because he is absolutely roasting them right now.
They're going to go through the whole litany of things, changing coverages, you know, what are we going to do, put a man on him. The big thing to me is treat it like a good pitcher treats pitching a game. Change your timing, change your location. So sometimes you're up on him, sometimes you're back. Just change up the looks that he sees and make him just a little bit more hesitant. Hey.
Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. They'll run here with Bo.
Okay, so why did they make me go that way when I had an open cut?
It's a 6-yard pickup and it gets into 2nd and 4. On 2nd down and 4, Mayfield. That is caught at the 7-yard line.
Dang, he got juked out his shot.
8 to 5, pickup of 3. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though
I like that hit,
couldn't turn it into much more.
Well, they've had a great impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is the more
2 yards out. That's weird.
Extra point was hooking, but he does make it through. And that cuts the lead to 28-14. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Redskins take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, calling, they're locked in really well.
Touchdown, Washington.
Great job. Touchdown,
a great play there. 75 yards. And the Redskins are able to stretch the lead out further. Not a whole lot to recap on that drive. Just one play, 75 yards to the house.
Yeah, it's a long way to go. And remember, rarely is it a straight line 75 yards, too. Got to have a little extra in there. So whatever the final number is, a well-deserved seat on the bench, a little oxygen if he wants it as well.
This one taken just inside the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They trail here by 24 points. Got to get going soon, you'd have to think, as they come up first and 10. They're going to be stopped up on this first down run. He might have gotten back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. We remind you that coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will be alongside him with highlights and analysis from Orlando of this first half of action. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And out across midfield, down to the 45. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Redskins' 45-yard line.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, and all of them going together as one unit downfield. A really nice pickup.
And this time, not quite to the 30. He'll be down at the 31-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Mayfield to throw it. And this is caught at the 8. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. 25 yards that time. From the gun, Mayfield. That is caught by Rice. He's got a Jets touchdown. It's a 6-yard
touchdown. So both of our defense sucks.
And the Jets are able to close the gap just a bit.
Yes, indeed. Jerry Rice from Mississippi Valley State. I remember we broke into the league, and the nickname Flash was the one he was trying to get to catch on. As it turned out, he didn't need a nickname. 197 receiving touchdowns in the NFL, added on 10 rushing, and even had a fumble recovery for a total of 208 in his career.
By far, the most all-purpose touchdown in league history. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
First question, using this bin. Where is the basement? Oh, would you look at that? There's already a trap pretty much right there. Hey, the basement.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And now consider the lead. The question is, how much is good enough? Are you going for more?
It's the NFL. There's never enough, I believe, because they get reeled in all the time when you sit on the ball. I think that they will try and move the ball downfield and try and squeeze a few more points out of this first half. They'll be careful. They'll be a little bit cautious at times. But also, they will attack downfield and try to get position for at least 3 points.
Oh, he's got a man wide open. Complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. The catch and run pays off to the tune of 35 yards. He's going to wind up and air it out into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde, and he'll return it to the 24-yard line.
When you're in man coverage, you have help over the top, you become a much more confident defender. Trail the receiver and know that someone over the top can make a play. And that's exactly what happened here. The free safety coming up with the interception.
Yeah, you asshole.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts. As it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one.
I'm going to slap you. I don't know if I can make this.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
There's one.
Don't let him free.
Working out of the gun. Mayfield. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. Now the Jets going to use the second of their three timeouts. As they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action.
Why is baseman dropper right?
Mayfield looks to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Holt.
Let's go.
Touchdown, Jets.
We're back in it.
Big play there. In the final seconds of the first half. As his guys are back within a single score.
Why am I so bad?
Dawson tacks on the point after. And that will get him one closer. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away.
Super bad at listening.
Come on, boy. Let's go.
Oh, you're dead.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Or they can even run a screen. You know, something that feels somewhat safe.
Tries for Rice, intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore.
I was gonna do the strat when I did on here. We're gonna stand there and wait for them to fucking.
So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. And we're gonna get a timeout.
Damn, my kicker can't even make that, bro.
I just stay here.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends.
It's our time. It's our time.
Final play of the half, Mayfield.
Dang.
Couldn't get a throw off. The pressure, maybe that was for the best.
Please tell me I get ball. I don't remember. I think he got the kick return in the first place, so I think I do get ball.
Now, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here.
All right, we need to reposition.
Yes.
Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring?
Thank you.
Underway in quarter three.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't
it?
When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
I wasn't close enough. I need one more chance.
Double time.
Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. He can't avoid the pressure. Redskins get there. Defensive end DeMarcus Lawrence applied the heat. They're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. A good pickup there. 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch. But you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
And I think they've given up. Where is the hatch?
Let's go! Come on now. Let's go! We teeing up. We came to play, baby.
Is the game that time, second and goal. So the ball position now at the three, here's second and goal. They'll try the ground game.
Let's go!
End zone, touchdown, Jets. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the afternoon, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Dawson able to connect on the extra point. And that will tie our game here in the third. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here.
Where are all the possible entries and exits?
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game. We'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect. But overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
It is tough to complete pass against zone defenses. The windows that you see open, they shrink pretty rapidly. How about being able to hit a moving target against a zone before the next guy can get there and make a play on the ball?
Not easy for any quarterback, no matter the situation. And there, the defense won the battle.
Hey, why wouldn't it let me click onto him?
Before reaching the 45-yard line. 17 yards that time at a Washington first.
Hey, let's get this, get this.
Now a handoff looking right. And a good pickup there. He gets about six up to midfield.
That's it, baby.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
Here we go, D.
From midfield now on second down. Midfield. And his pass incomplete. He was trying to get it to George Kittle, his tight end. But now it's third down.
So this is what happens when you throw interceptions. That confident veneer that you have gets chipped away a little bit. Maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, underthrowing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions maybe in the back of his mind. Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Here's Mayfield. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Sacked there by Avery Williamson, the linebacker. On fourth down, they snap it to Mayfield.
Let's go, you suck!
Complete. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off.
Let's go. Who goes for that? He's so dumb.
On first and 10, Mayfield.
Oh, I threw that pick.
Woo! Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. Line of scrimmage again, the 37 as they line up second and 10. Throwing Mayfield. They set up the screen to Bow.
Woo! Let's go, baby.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Mayfield now. Five straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. They run on first down with Jackson. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out, but I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great
penetration. I'll take three, but kind of want more than three.
All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
But there was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Third and long for Mayfield.
No!
You hear the calls for a
take my field goal.
I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant you the flag.
No, I'm with you. Perfect. Contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. And Dawson's kick is good. And that will break our tie and give them a three-point lead. So a good kick there. They put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time.
Let's go, boy.
Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the three.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just want to go past it.
Check.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Hey, alert 33.
They go play action. Mayfield.
That's to the right side, complete to kick. I know how to stop that. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Back now at FedEx Field. Very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. That's a gain of four as we slip inside of 4 minutes left in regulation. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Mayfield. Thank you, because that should have been an obvious pick.
And keep moving things forward. Almost his bread and butter. It's a good running back dive play.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Looking to throw. And that is incomplete.
So it looked like maybe his third or his fourth read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
So here comes the trusty battle-tested Adam Vinatieri for a big kick. It'll be a 47-yard attempt from the left hash. And this one is
right. That was probably the smartest thing he's done all game.
And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. So with less than a minute gone by here in this fourth quarter, the field goal there gets this thing back to even.
And it's setting up for a fantastic finish, isn't it, partner? It's been a well-played game, a hard-hitting game. The fans are into it. The announcers are into it. This is going to be a great fourth quarter.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
Met a fan base yet that wants to drive in with a kick.
Oh.
Then the extra point. That's it.
That one good for 26 and a first down. In Washington territory now. Here's first and 10. Right at the 40. They run on first down as they get about three. Second and 7 forthcoming. Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Just know what I'm running.
They'll try to throw here. Mayfield. Now they go screen. It's complete. 11 yards there. First down.
Let's go. Let's
He's
go.
Having a big
Let's
game go. Through the air, and sometimes those smart decisions just dump it off. That's how you continue to have big games through the air.
I agree totally. That's a great analogy, a great way to check, put check. It, because he doesn't get too greedy where everything has to be pushed down.
Dang. Trying to create Why was Todd Gurley out there?
You dump it off and take that nice gain, and things add up, and now you have the kind of game he's having.
Three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. Second and 13.
50 to Mike. Ain't no such thing as a loss. We
Getting
take
down
win.
To the good what? Stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. They've got a third down, but they are in field goal range already. On third down, this is Jackson, and he's not going to sniff the first down here. He stopped at the 25. Call it a gain of four, and it'll bring up fourth down. Have to kick this field goal, don't you?
No question about it. Look at the clock. Look at the situation. Kick the field goal.
Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing.
Oh, this is risky for the biscuit.
Let's go, Dean.
Mayfield to throw for it on four.
Let's go. Let's go.
Jets touchdown. 25 yards for the touchdown. As his guys have taken.
Sometimes in life you take risks. Let's go. Oh my God.
Looking at the clock and I'm thinking there's a long way to go in this one.
Ideally, they would have liked to milk a little bit more time off now on the other side. sideline, you start to get the crew together and say, this is what we practice the two-minute drill for, right?
Yeah, you hope you've been in that situation before, and if you haven't, you just have the confidence. Hey, let's go down there and get this thing done. But, boy, that's a big score right there to give them the advantage.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time, able to get three. That's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker caught on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah. They'll be going for six. He'll look to throw.
Let's go.
A crusher there as it's intercepted.
Picked off. Let's go, you bum. You're a bum.
Right at the 44-yard line.
You're a bum.
Brandon, I'm not going to tell him that you called him old in our pregame meeting, but this guy has been around a long time. There's a trick in the book. He knows it. He probably even wrote a few chapters. And this is what he's always had.
Dang.
And that's a nose for the football. He's able to come away here with the interception.
The Redskins now going to use the first of their three timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Mayfield now. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete.
Let's go, you bum.
Yards there. First down.
Well, they got the yardage they needed there. Picked up the first down. Got out of bounds. How about the urgency that they had as well as the understanding where they are on the field?
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. On the run, it's Bo Jackson. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Hey, a lot of points have been scored in this game against them, but tally that one on the side of the defense.
Do you think maybe, possibly, it could be a little bit of a changer for them? Maybe not a game changer, but a little bit of a momentum one that maybe they can string together some pretty good plays and slow them down.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Now a fake on the give here as they try to run pass option. Looks to throw, fires right side. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now Mayfield.
He burnt them. No, he burnt them. He got the luckiest hit of his life.
And the Redskins defense going to take over on the turnover on downs. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a
pick.
Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted.
Let's go. Get him out of here, coach. Thank you for the YouTube video. Let's go, boy. Came back on him.
Let's go.